with me now. I know what I'm talking about.
She opened her mouth with wisdom, and it's important to, when you think about things, to think through things. Sit down and think through the process. And in her tongue is the law of kindness. You ain't got nothing really kind to say? Look around at somebody and say, you ain't got nothing kind to say. Because there is a law, and that law is called the law of kindness. Amen. Try being kind sometimes. You'd be surprised. Oh, I hear too many amen. You know, kindness means you got to get outside yourself. You got to decide yourself and go up beyond who you really are. Amen. And sometimes when folks are kind, you always come up with what they up to now. What she want now? What he want now? Because he's being real kind to me. Kindness ain't going to kill you.
That's true.
You got stuff in your medicine cabinet that will kill you quicker than kindness. She looked well to the ways of her household and eating not the bread of idleness. If you're just walking around and doing nothing, I want you to know that idleness, if your hands are idle, they have nothing but the devil's workshop. Amen. Always working and conning and always doing things, always manipulating and trying to keep somebody out of something. I can see that everybody else can. Amen. Try a little loving kindness. Amen. Try the law of kindness and see on the law of kindness work every time.
Yes, it will. Yes, it will. Amen.
Her children rise up, in verse 28 says. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Sometimes you ought to just call your mama up and say, Mama, I want to just bless you. Amen. Let me show you how it works. Turn around to somebody and say, God bless you. God bless you. Turn around to somebody else and say, God bless you.
God bless you.
All you got to do is say that to your mama sometime. Amen. I know some of y'all think I'm too old to be putting my head on my mama's lap. But every now and then you got to go to mama and say, Mama, can I just lay my head on your lap? You're never too old to thank God for mama and what mama brought you through. And what mama prayed for you when you couldn't get through. When you was out on your own and everybody else gave up on you. The man threw the book at you. So mama was right there. Mama stood through thick and thin, blood and down, through in and out. Mama was right there.
Preach
it. You might not want to hear the mother. I know I got a good mother, amen.
Amen.
And I know how hard my mama worked, amen. Yes. I was there for them thin times, no difficult times. Yes. I was there when she was lonely and didn't have nobody to talk to.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Brother, I want to tell you my mama. Her children arise up and it was love of us. It's amazing in the hour in which we live how one woman can take care of 10, 11 children, but 10, 11 children can't take care of one woman.
Yeah.
That's amazing to me. Always busy doing things. Don't even come by and say, Mama, I bought you some groceries. Mama, have a piece of money. The only time Mama see them is when they want something.
That's the truth.
Amen. You see, my mama had me, amen. My mama had me. had an appointed time for all this. This ain't by chance that where we are today is happening.
That's true.
If God didn't have blessed my mama to have me, you would not have heard that song, "Pain Don't Last Always."
That's right.
You would have never heard the discord on that throne, on that song. Why? Because God has an appointed time.
Yes, he does.
Amen.
You need to understand one thing in this life. You can never choose your mother, and you can never choose your child.
Amen. 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 Preach on, brother. Preach on. Preach on.
One thing I'm talking about, a balance of power.
Yes. Yes.
See, God gave woman three keys. Listen to me, brother. Listen to me. God gave woman three keys.
Listen.
Amen.
One to the kitchen.
Uh-huh.
One to the bedroom. And one to the generation. And you men folks, if you ain't got enough common sense, you can get locked out of any one of those. Oh, I'm gonna get back to the message here, talking about balance of power. See, the whole while you think it's men folks, you ain't got the power. The wiser you get, the better you're gonna be off. If you come and talk to me sometime, I can tell you all about it.
All right. All right.
Oh my God, let me get to the end of this. Her husband also, verse 28, the husband always also and said, and he praises her. Right? I thank my wife all the time, amen? And I don't have to wait till Mother's Day or special occasion. I can buy her candy. Come on. Give her money, take her out. Ain't no special occasion. So when the year rolls by, I ain't forgot about it because I've been giving her all along.
That's right. Amen. That is the truth.
Amen. You see, the same way I got my wife. Who's sitting here right now, amen?
Preach on.
I'm talking about 33 years of marriage now.
Preach on.
I'm talking about the same way I got her is the same way I keep her.
That's right.
Oh, somebody. You can't get married and switch up. Because marrying somebody don't mean they're going to change.
That's true. Preach on.
You married for the wrong reason.
Amen.
Married because you truly love them, amen?
That's true.
Everybody else might not be in love with them, amen?
That's true.
That's before I gave you.
Amen.
Amen. That's why I always tell young people, if you want to get married or think about getting married, please get some counsel.
Amen.
You don't want me to counsel, get somebody going to tell it to you like it is.
That's
amen. Come on, somebody.
Amen. That's the truth.
Verse 30 says here, verse 29 says, many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excel them all.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, better than the virtuous one of all. Verse 30 said, favor is deceitful. Be careful with somebody that can you do me a favor?
Uh-huh.
Only when I want me doing a favor, I want God to do me a favor.
That's
come on, somebody.
That's true.
Sometimes when you somebody do you a favor, they got something attached. I'm not talking like this. You know when they say, especially when it comes down to money, look at my brother. Can you do me a favor?
Uh-huh.
You know what's getting ready to come next, don't you? How much you want, amen? Do me a favor, I'm going to see you Friday.
Ooh.
Come Friday, pay when are you looking? Come on, somebody. You know you need your money back, amen? You don't send them to Monday and you say, you know what? Hey, look, I'm going to catch you this coming Friday, amen? That's what I'm trying to say. Always trying to catch you, now you chasing them for your money.
That's it.
So let me just show you something about it. If you want to keep your friends, don't loan no money.
That's it.
If they're asking you money, say, listen, then we're going to have to stop being friends. Well, yeah, if I loan you money, we're going to have to stop being friends. What are you talking about? Because see, I'm funny about my money. And if I loan you money, you don't pay it back to me, then we're going to have a problem.
Amen.
Y'all ain't going to be talking.